I'm Yasmin Hurd. I'm the director of the Addiction Institute at the Icahn School of Medicine at Mount Sinai in New York. I'm also a professor in psychiatry, neuroscience, and pharmacological sciences here. Interestingly, I think the reason I am a neuroscientist is because I had a professor who was a great ally. Even though I was a student in college, he walked my walk because of what he did. I have tried to be an ally to many junior people, especially who don't understand the path. And I think that that's one of the things that's so important. If we want to cure disease, we need to bring everybody to the table. Throughout the majority of my early career, people expected me to fail. There was not a support. It was like I was a weird person, this black girl who loved science, and worse, who loved the brain. And I have no idea why I love the brain, but they didn't know where to put me. And that was very difficult, feeling alone, being alone. It can be a very isolating career. Even though science for me is about teamwork, it is very isolating. And so allyship is a context of also making people feel like they belong. And as I got more senior and I met some like-minded sisters, those sisters helped me. They weren't black, they weren't brown, they were just wonderful women. And that to me made a big difference, so that you had someone to speak with. You had someone who you could, who understood, even if they couldn't really walk the path with you, they tried to walk in your shoe to understand what you were going through. And I think that that is allyship. Perhaps being a leader, I represent, you know, I'm a role model for a lot of people who don't see people who look like them in the role that I have. And so it's easier for them to come to talk with me. A lot of times I think that people don't understand, and leaders, just having a safe space to talk, you improve allyship just naturally, because then people can feel that they're being heard, and it is about making sure that they are also visible. I think a lot of times we, and often people have done that, take credit for things from others. Let those individuals get the visibility. We are already here as leaders. We do not need to keep, you know, patting ourselves on the back. This is me, me, me. So I think that's another way for me that we can help others and improve DEI and allyship. All the people in my team, whether it's students, postdocs, everyone mentors a summer student. And we have students coming from different walks of life. And I think that that then makes a ripple effect to the next generation and to the next. And I do hope in the future, there will always be differences. That's the beauty of human beings. That's the beauty of the world. We're all different. It's whether or not that difference is looked at in a negative manner rather than embraced. End of the day, everyone just wants an opportunity to be seen, to be heard, and to be valued for who they are as a person, as a scientist. I do think that we are getting there. And I hope that, as I said, you know, one day it won't matter what we all look like, what we all sound like, we're all at the table. Mm-hmm.